Same bee yard, different new employee. We got Rory here, and a different circumstance. This is a swarm that's up in a tree, fairly low, so it's not too awkward to get at. We have a bucket attached to a long, long pole that we can use for where they're up a bit higher. If it's any higher than that, we just let the swarm go. It's not worth climbing a tree and injuring yourself to catch a swarm. But this one's not too bad. We didn't happen to have a ladder, so that's a live beehive underneath Rory. And we've got it kind of propped up so it's not going to tip over on him. And he's just going to use a bucket and jab it up into the swarm or around the swarm to get it to drop off and so we can catch the swarm. He's pruned a little bit around the area, but now that he's getting close to the swarm, he'll give the smoke to the bees. Just a little bit of light smoke around them. Doesn't take a lot. And that's good. We won't ask Rory to stick his hand into that swarm, but I'm kind of itching to. So I'll set that aside. Now he's going to take he's going to prune nice and close there, trying not to jar that swarm. Now get the rest of that branch out of the way, Rory.
This one?
No, down lower. Yeah, just so you've got a good clear path. Now you're going to want to have the bucket. And that's good, yeah. You could prune that one that's poking out on this side.
This one here?
No, coming right through the swarm. Yeah, that one. We're getting there. We want to be able to surround the swarm with this bucket. Okay, there's a lot of weight there, so they could really easily fall off the branch.
Yeah.
So we get that under there. And now our bucket is barely big enough, Rory. You are going to get some bees on you.
Alrighty.
Actually, hold the bucket, and I'm going to get you to trim off that one other one at the same time.
Just in case it falls here.
Yeah, get it that right up around the bees. Just in case it falls, we can prune that one off. There we go. Okay, it came down a bit. Yeah. Now move that up as far as you can. And they're not quite ready to fall yet.
I might have to get above them here.
No. That's going to have a lot of weight on it. Am I going to get underneath these two?
Sure. Oh.
Now I'm going to... Okay, I'm ready to catch it.
All right. Okay, let me just prune this one a little bit more. There we go. All right.
Can you reach it there?
I think so.
Oh, well, we lost a few.
Okay,
now what you're going to do is just give it a sharp jab upwards.
Yep. I think I got it.
Well, you got it?
I think I got most of them here.
Okay. I'll clear the path here.
Now, grab that.
Yeah, I got it. And then you can prune a bit more. Good.
Go.
Fantastic. Keep pruning.
There we go. Should be free.
Every swarm's different, as they say, so it takes a little improvising, but hey, we got it. That feels like about 8, maybe even 10 pounds of bees.
Yeah, let's see this.
And we got maybe a couple ounces of bees on Rory there, so that's not bad. That's a pretty good ratio. So he's going to walk over here and not trip.
Perfect.
Now we're going to do the same thing. We've got a nuke box set up here with the frames in it. One frame of honey and three empties. They'll have a lot of honey in them. You can even put foundation in here because they're all primed to build comb. Their wax glands are all set up and going. So we're going to give a little bit of smoke and then just lay it down on the ground right there. And then we'll pull the branch out.
Okay, that's probably
yeah. If we'd caught them all just as a lump of bees, we'd shake them sharply at the beginning of that. But we got all these branches in the way, so just pull the branches out slowly. Nice. Now pull that back a bit, and get right back to the beginning there. And now you can give it a sharp shake without banging it down, right? Good, beautiful.
That's most of them out of there.
Yep. More. And there is next to nothing on the tree. They're not actually flying today. It's too cool. So there aren't a lot in the air, but sometimes a lot go back to the spot and you have to go back and catch some more.
Mm-hmm.
So now just take that branch and give it a tremble kind of shake over top there. Beautiful. Okay, I'll just clear everything out of the way. That's a nice pile of bees, isn't it?
That is, that's a great pile of bees.
Okay, now give them a smoke right at your end.
Sure.
And we'll get them running in. Sometimes you see the queen, sometimes we don't. A lot of people will catch them right into the box, and you can do that, but then put the frames in later. No, there's no real right way of doing this. But I'm not even sure they're all going to fit in this box. It was a handy box. There's the queen. Now it's possible there's more than one in here. Sometimes you have more than one colony swarm at once and they're in the air and then they merge together and you get more than one queen. So I did see her. She's an unmarked queen. So I just didn't see her well enough to tell if she's a virgin or not. So we know they have a queen.
Okay.
And they will stay here now that we know they have a queen. So I'm just going to leave her alone. Like that's all we really need to do is see that they have a queen.
Yeah.
And we can just let those bees run in there. And they'll be charging along. You can start to see them streaming there.
Mm-hmm.
And ones up here are just starting to fan their wings.
Yeah.
And bend their abdomen a bit to expose the Nazanoff gland. And I'm just keeping an eye out for another queen too. That's a drone, I believe. Yep. And the drone there. See, that drone's got quite a yellow.
Oh, that's a drone there too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but if your eyes are stopping on a drone, at least they're seeing something different. That's good. Quite often, the queen will be running on top of the other bees. Not today. Okay, that's it. We did it. Well done, Rory.